Hey YouTube, and you've reached Tell Samira. So today I'm talking about horrible bosses and how to deal with them. I know we've all had a horrible boss, or maybe you had a friend who had a horrible boss, but I'm sure if you stick with me, you can relate to this. And if you're dealing with this current situation, God bless you. I hope you get the help you need, and please stick around. So I have a lot of experience with horrible bosses, and a lot of this has been my fault for trying to be a people pleaser and trying to maintain my job. And so I put up with a lot of crap. So today I don't feel like I put up with that crap. I think the older I get, the more likely I am to just say, you know, whatever, I'm going to leave this situation. I'm not dealing with it. I don't know. It's something about age that gives me a new perspective on things. And I try to push toward being an entrepreneur as much as possible because I'm just fed up with horrible bosses. In my experience, because I work in mental health and I've worked in social services, the majority of my bosses have been females. So I've had a lot of problems with them. I've not had many males, but when I have dealt with the males, it was really no problems or even minor problems. But it's something about the females that I kept running into, and things that I would notice is that instead of them being professional and talking about the job, these people usually like to talk about your emotions. Like, for instance, I had bosses say things to me like, "Are you okay?" You know, it's that look like if you don't know better, you would really think that they're concerned about you, but they're not. They're just trying to be very messy and manipulative. So they're like, "Are you okay? Is everything all right with you? You know, your emotions seem different. You seem different." You know, I used to fall for that. Like, "Huh? What do you mean?" Even though I knew it wasn't true. But how do you deal with that? Now I do like things like this. You have to master a poker face with these people because they're looking for anything to see where they can poke your butt, push your buttons. And so if you give them reactions on your face, they like, "I got them." So you can't be like, "Huh, what?" or crying. Please don't cry. Don't ever cry. Get up and leave a meeting. Excuse yourself. Don't let these people see you cry, because they are like vultures and they will just come down upon you like, "Rah!" if they see you crying. So please don't give them that energy, because they love it. But yeah, so they always looking at your emotions to see if you're okay. You know, they may even try to compare you to other people, like, "Oh, well, so-and-so is doing this and so-and-so is doing that." You know, what I suggest to do with that is to remind them, you know, it's just to always bring the focus back on your job and what you're doing. And I let people know, I accept constructive criticism. What is it exactly that you would like me to do? And then that's what I'll do. You know, I've even had horrible bosses who would basically stalk me. This one agency I worked for was through a temp agency, and this one lady, she kept on always like, "Where were you? Why did it take you so long to get X, Y, and Z?" And I'm like, you know, she would be on vacation and would have other people watching you, and she'll call the person she wanted me to report to. "What time did she get there?" You know, I'm like, "Please, lady, enjoy your vacation." And the thing was, it's like, maybe I took my lunch break or my other 10-minute breaks that I had throughout the day. Maybe I went to the restroom, you know, and she's calculating all of this time. And, you know, and what I learned how to deal with these people that's watching your every move, that's always looking for some reason to go off on you or some reason to be mad, is to do a lot of things, most of the things by email. So I'm always like, "This is what time I got there. This is what I did through the day." And I didn't like to do that because I like to work independently. And I'm not, you know, I don't like people following up behind me. But if you can't change jobs, which I do suggest with horrible bosses, to me, life is just too short, you know, so why not change jobs? But that's just me. We can't always change jobs. I do know that in a perfect world, but this is not a perfect world. But yes, I like to keep these people updated at all times. "This is what I did through the morning, XYZ. This is what I did after lunch, XYZ." And this way you have a paper the email trail of what you're doing, because these people will throw you under the bus. The crazy thing is that same boss who was questioning my every move, me and this other lady were bringing in so much money for the organization. She kept praising us at these monthly team meetings, and it was just the craziest. This is how I knew she was a toxic manipulator. It's because in front of other people, she was always going on about how much money we were bringing in, how great we were. But in private, she was doing these crazy things with me, asking me Oh, telling me that she was like, why were you in the assistant director's office? What were you talking about? You know, and I'm like, what? What? Why are you asking me that? She's like, why you just can't tell me what are you talking about? And things like that, you know, I suggest to have a notebook because I never did it, but I wish I had done this, is to have a notebook and that way just take down notes. Anytime you start seeing that it's going chaotic or something not feeling right to you, trust your gut and start taking notes. And you know what I would suggest is start, once you're taking notes, they probably ask, why are you taking notes? And I'd say, oh, because everything you say is very important to me and I want to make sure that I'm just keeping track of all that so I can have it, you know, just as a reminder. And really in my mind, the reminder is just in case if I have to take your tail to HR or have to bring up some type of litigation or whatever against you, I'm writing notes so I can know everything it is that you're saying. These people, I find that these horrible bosses, they don't like to be questioned. You know, if you ask them a question trying to follow up about a project, they get upset. And I know people want to keep their jobs, but you have to decide what's most important for you. For me at this point, it's respect and being content at the job I'm at. So I have learned to speak up for myself. Whereas some of these people, they'll say things in front of you to try to embarrass you in front of other people. I've had that happened where I just sat there and not said anything thinking, oh, I don't want to lose my job. But you know what? I would rather lose my job than, and I've never been fired, but I'd rather lose my job than deal with a horrible boss and be intimidated and be feeling weak and disgusted with myself because I'm not standing up for myself. It's like I would rather be out, you know, out of that job than to not be able to live with myself and suffering from panic attacks and depression and all type of emotional, you know, mental illness because of a job. You know, it's like it's not worth it when you consider the weight that you may gain, the lack of peace that it may bring you, and the bad relationships you may be having with people at your house. It's just not worth it. Oh, and also, if you have not already, if you like what I'm saying, please like this video, share it if you know somebody who's dealing with a horrible boss, and also please subscribe and hit the notification bell. And right before I get back into it, I do want to say, if you have not gotten my book, I Should Have Worn a Curtain, A Tale of Bulimia, Self-Loathing, and Romance by Samira Alexander, please do so. This is my first book, a very short story. You can get the information. It's sold at Amazon right now. It's available, and the information will be down in my description box. It is a fiction story based on women's fiction, African-American fiction, but not just for African-Americans, but for anybody. So please look down in the description. If you've already gotten it, please leave me an Amazon review and a Goodreads review. Thanks. But anyway, so back to my thing. So I've had bosses that are so horrible that they'll even lie. For instance, I had one, and this is so shameful. I have a PsyD in clinical psychology, which is a doctorate in clinical psychology. And the woman who was my supervisor, she had a master's degree, which was totally fine. We weren't licensed, you know. And there was another woman who also had a master's degree. We were both working at the same level, and the woman who was over us, like I said, she had the master's. Well, she would lie to us and tell us that she was licensed, and I don't know why, because you can look online to see who's licensed and who's not. I mean, I wasn't licensed, you know. I don't know why she felt the need to tell me that, but she would bring it up every now and again, like, yeah, you all, yes, I like, well, I'm licensed, and you know, I got licensed. And the other girl I worked with, she was the one who looked it up, and she was like, Samira, you know, just lying. I'm like, what? She's like, yes, I looked it up online. She is not licensed. So I looked it up, and the woman was not licensed. Crazy. But she was always coming at us with something. Like, we were in a group meeting, a meeting, just the three of us once, and she accused me and the other woman of not giving her enough information. So these horrible bosses, they'll accuse you of things, but they won't be clear with what they want from you, their expectations. It's like they feel like you're a mind reader. So she's like, you're not giving me enough information. It's like, what information do you want? We have about four or five different clients, and every month we send you the report, we send them. And all the reports share some things in common, and some have things that's different. So what more is it that you'd want, you know? But she could never give us a full answer. So she said, told me and the other lady, and we just both happen to be black and she's white, which was totally unacceptable. Where do they do this? But she tells us two black women, are you afraid that I'm going to beat, whip, or punish you if you give me more information. And I'm like, oh my God, what? And it had just been so much drama. I had started crying, and I'm embarrassed to say, because I was just overwhelmed with everything that had been happening. And I walked out. You know, that's how I learned you don't bust out crying somewhere. I don't care how overwhelmed you are, you don't bust out crying. But anyway, I end up having to take that organization to some, we had to do some intervention, I'll say. And leave it at that, because yeah, because you're not gonna be telling me you do I need to be beat, whipped, or punished, because not today, sweetie. But anywho, so that's the kind of stuff. And like I'm saying, let me know in the comment section, is it just me? But it was like to the point that I really didn't want to work with women anymore, because it's like, why so much toxicity with these women? You know, like I said, I've had people tell me to do an assignment. As soon as I do it, they're like, why'd you do that? And I'm like, telling my supervisor, because you told me. No, I didn't tell you that. Why would you think I tell? Oh my God, the games that they'll play. So this is why I strongly suggest not only just writing things down, but sending emails. And if you know these people lie on you, I send emails first, and I'll say, hey, just as a follow-up, you told me to do X, Y, Z, Z, Z today, and you said you need it done by so-and-so. I am just confirming that I understood you correctly. This way, you're recording everything. And that's how, when I had my most toxic boss, it was two of them. Oh, my God. But I just started putting everything, you know, in the email. I had one who told me to do a project. I said, you know, the other girl is going to get mad because she's going to say I'm stepping on her toes. She's like, well, you tell her to come to me. And so I did the assignment, and then the girl, of course, got mad, and I said, well, hey, so-and-so said you have to talk to her. And then that manager ended up lying, was like, huh, what do you mean? I don't, huh? And then as soon as everyone left out the room, then I talked to her. I'm like, so you don't remember telling me that? She's like, oh yeah, I told you. And but it was game. Because it's like, oh, as soon as nobody's around, you remember. But then when it's just me and you, now all of a sudden you don't remember. And it's like, I don't know what it is, if these horrible bosses are just really messy people just in general, or if they, I don't know if they find, if they're jealous of different women who come in and doing the job. But it's like, I'm not there trying to get anybody's job. I'm not trying to take anybody's shine. And it still comes up that these people are crazy. And the job that I was attempting, and you know, that woman, she ended up taking me and the other girl to the HR because she kept saying that me and the other girl were having problems. It's like, no, she was, the manager happened to be in the cahoots with the other temp. It was the craziest thing. I believe both of them were narcissists, but that's just me. So she ended up getting mad at the narc temp and then turned on her. And so she took both of us to HR, saying normally that they would just fire temps, but since we were bringing in so much money and we were so good workers, except for the issues we had together, they didn't want to fire us. And then basically, they were like, well, yeah, say everything that happened, that's been happening. And I'm like, I told the manager, I said, I've never come to you about this woman. I said, I've always just done my job. I said, anytime it's been a discussion, it's you telling me what she said about me. But I've never come to you with this. So I'm not understanding how you're saying that I'm the problem and that we're both taking away your time because we're both bringing this drama to you. I said, I've never talked to you about this. And she was like, I know, I never said you did, but I'm saying it's taking my time. And I was surprised that she acted so crazy in front of HR. I'm like, at least I can commend her that she wasn't trying to be a different person in front of the HR lady. She was crazy all around. And then the woman also was there, was also there, who lied and told me to do an assignment. Even she was rolling her eyes and acting crazy. The HR lady told me and the temp said that those two bosses were star employees with the company. And so we may not understand everything that's going on, but just do everything they say. And for that, I knew I had to leave, because it lets me know what I suspected all the time. You don't just get a toxic boss and get two of them. You get them like that because it's bad at the top. And that was social services. So it was bad at the top. And they knew what was going down or going on at that lower level, and they put up with it. So that's why I say, if you can, go get away as fast as you can. Don't fool yourself thinking that something is going to get better. Yeah, they may have a fish fry and do something nice, but you can always know that it's going to get back bad, because that's what it is. It's like a domestic violence relationship where the abuser will attack the person, but then do something very nice, and it makes the victim think like, oh, this person is going to change, but then the craziness always happens again, the abuse, the violence happens again, then something nice. clients. It's always a vicious cycle. That's how it is at a bad job. That's why you'll see those Facebook posts and about people saying, hey, you know, every, or at least three times a month, I'm dusting off my resume. You know, they're doing that because they probably in a bad situation, something crazy happens, then something good, something crazy, then something good, and they fall for it and they stay, but in reality, it's not going to get better. So get out if you can. Thank you so much for watching. This has been Tell Samira. Please give me a like, share this video, comment, and also hit that notification bell. If you haven't got my book, please do so today. I Should Have Worn a Curtain, A Tale of Bulimia, Self-Loathing, and Romance. It's a fiction story, women's fiction, available now at Amazon. Bye. Peace.